Hi, it's Gene, retired in Mexico, and we ask one question on this channel, which is, do they write them and do they sing them like they used to? So a lot of people, young and old, they think the old music is better. I think I read that 73% of all content is classic rock. So anyhow, I'm making a case for the 21st century, and today we're going to hit up Sia. Now, her song Chandelier has 1.3 billion plays on Spotify, and I don't think I've heard this song. I'm pretty sure I haven't. I've done a deep dive into the lyrics. Let's go ahead and hit it up.
This has the obvious answer on it. Wait, it's a real electronic combo.
So I stop once or twice to help with blocking, otherwise I just let the video run. But the song was okay, and then bam, that chorus comes right in, right? So that's great. And I'm enjoying the dancer. We'll talk more about the song in a moment. Let's keep going.
Nice synth at the end. And there's that home again. That's really unusual, that electronic home.
All right, so, we probably ought to, hit up a live version of this so that I can hear it again. What did I like about it? Okay, well, first of all, the lyrics. I did a deep dive before hitting this, and that ambivalence about whether I should keep partying, but then there's the morning after, and I'm having a good time, but I'm having a lot of shame, and it's that razor's edge that you're on with she's not talking about it. Well, some say she's talking about addiction. I don't know her story, but absolutely. The way I've heard a lot of people described it, can't live without it, can't live with it. So, that party thing, it seems like the great life, right? But there's always the flip side to the coin, and she does capture that very well with the lyrics, and her voice is interesting, I like it, and then the dancer was terrific. You know, in terms of electropop, again, it's one of those songs that even though I've never heard it before, it sounds like I've heard it before. It seems like a pretty typical chord progression, and it's similar to a lot of other things that I've heard. So what makes it unique? I think her voice. She's got some real interesting phrasing there, and she hits some high notes. And then the other thing I really like is the way the chorus hits. It hits really hard. I can't say I love the song, but I'm pretty high on the lyrics. Well, high might be it might be the wrong word to use, but you know what I mean. I think the lyrics are really cool and the singing's cool. I'm gonna give it a B+. I think it's I understand why it's got 1.3 billion, because it's very mainstream, I think. And I guess I was looking for something maybe just a little more unique, but her voice is unique, so I'll give her that. And B+ is a great rating, means I like the song. But that's it. In terms of the instrumentation, it just seemed normal, typical. I've heard so many of these electropop songs now that they kind of sound, I don't want to say they sound the same, but there's a similarity. maybe I'm mincing words there, but yeah, good stuff. Can't put it in A territory, but I'd like to see her do this song or another song live. I am interested in her. And that's it. Let's keep the video short. Thanks for joining me, and as we say here in Mexico, buen día.